4K 60 tecken. Eller 50, ja. Eller vad säger man?
Yeah, so we just slept our first night here. You know, you have the Ritsem boat that goes over just right over there. Walked about 5-6 kilometers. Nice little bridge here. I don't have my map, so I'm just saying a bunch of words with no names. Sorry about that. Maybe I'll try to remember to put the text there so that you know what we're looking at. I got this nice big mountain and glacier there. A little cold during the night, got down to about 3 degrees. And just where I'm currently at, there's a lot of, you know, it's kind of like in a little goop and trees and really wet, so it ended up getting a lot of condensation, which means that one of the biggest advantages to having a separate inner and outer is that I can do something like this where I put my inner on the inside because it's still relatively dry, and I have my outer here on the outside so it's not getting everything wet because it's just really wet. So what I'm gonna do is, as we're walking and we take our first breakfast break, is basically just let it out, take it out and let it dry during the course of the day, and that'll be nice, just to avoid everything getting...
vänta. Superbra kväll för det. Hur något?
Nej, va?
Bra band på sidan där.
Läja fint och mjukt.
Du tar dig in i fjällen
utan
mat. Hur tänker du nu?
Det är fantastiskt.
Sen vi inte har någon som masserar fötterna
också. Ja, det kan bli hårt.
Och en dusch.
Tantet. Vad tar du för massa?
Ost och lukta. And just got done taking some shots with my Mamiya 7 here. And hopefully those turn out pretty nice. It's just a absolutely stunning... stunning view here. It's hard to capture these kind of places on video or on camera. Just never does it any justice. But hopefully I can capture some of it, and hopefully I can get some of it on the video here. Yeah. Been a good day hiking, about 23 kilometers maybe, and now we're here.
Jag tror att jag tar bort en sån här svarta klubb till korrektorn som sitter uppe på kameran. Den dyker på. Jag tog av den igår. Det är lite underligt att jag tar bort den på Kungsleden.
Ja.
Men... thank you. kan jag passa.
Så värt att vara åter i stallet, men så tomt. Så konstigt. Ja, det var någons dagbok.
Prisa Gud!
So, on my little wind meter, the wind is pushing between 8 and 14 meters per second. It's like 8 right now, or it pushes up to about 14 meters per second. Probably around 14-15 there. We thought we had found some pretty sheltered areas, but obviously not. This wind's hitting pretty hard. Got 12 pegs in, really holding the shelter down, but when the rain lets up I might just move the tent because I really want to get sleep tonight, and I don't necessarily like sleeping in heavy winds. I really do prefer sheltered areas, so we'll have to see. I'll probably pack up and move. There's a really sheltered area over there, so I'll probably move over there. But at least I know the tent can withstand some pretty heavy winds. But like any tent, I really don't want to sleep in heavy winds, because if you have your tent pitched in heavy winds, then there's no sleeping. So.
lilla stugan. Mm. Så kan man, om han finns stanna med där då, eller så går man vidare, kan man gå.
Go! Wet?
A little.
Yeah, so that's the end of my hiking with Johan here in northern Sweden. We started at Ritsem and about 160 kilometers made our way down Padjelanta trail, which is actually a pretty nice, easygoing trail, a lot of cottages along the way. And then we broke off and went around onto the Nordkalottleden, which is a considerably more wild trail. Not very many cottages, and just real rocky and just absolutely gorgeous trail. It's been about 8 days, 6 days walking, 2 days kind of traveling in between. You know, if you get a chance, check out Johan's channel, Vandringskanalen, so give him a watch. And as always, if you like the video, subscribe, share, do whatever you want.